Breaking news, California authorities have this morning released photos of the suspect who allegedly killed 10 people in a mass shooting. The shooting in Monterey Park happened shortly after thousands of people gathered for a Lunar New Year festival. These pictures right now coming into the newsroom. SWAT teams have swarmed a white van potentially linked to the deadly shooting. And the standoff is unfolding in Torrance, which is about 40 minutes away from the shooting scene itself. It's unclear what they've found inside that van at this point, waiting on further information. But SWAT team, we watched them, as you know, everyone at home, watched them raid that van just a short time ago, and we're not sure, it's unclear what they've found inside. So still waiting on that. But let's go live to US correspondent Jonathan Kearsley at the crime scene. As I mentioned, 40 minutes away. Jono, police have just addressed the media. What have they said?
Yeah, they have, interestingly, very cagey about what is exactly going on in Torrance, about 45 kilometres or so here from the shooting last night, where 10 people were shot dead inside a dance studio in this area that is very heavily populated by the Asian American community. Police had released an image of a suspect they said was heavily armed and dangerous, describing him as an Asian male. Those CCTV images taken from a nearby dance studio where they believe this man went to after the shooting here last night. There they believe he was tackled to the ground, the gun removed, and fled in a white van. That's what's caused the interest around this white van that we have seen all those Bearcats around in Torrance this morning. And you could see from those images that are coming into the newsroom now just how heavily armed those police are as they move into that area. Try and see exactly inside that white van and what is there. This is going to be crucial. Is the gunman, the suspect, going to be in this van, or is he not going to be there? These are questions that police could not answer at this media conference moments ago. Interestingly, though, what they did say was something quite sickening and quite disturbing. At an earlier press conference, a hospital had been mentioned where some of the injured victims were being treated, and then police had this to say.
Earlier, it may have been mentioned that they were at a specific hospital, and somebody called one of those hospitals to say something along the lines that they want to go and finish the job. That is absolutely horrible. So again, I don't believe that's the inference. Please, these victims and survivors are dealing with so much. Let's not traumatize them more.
So, Carl, as I mentioned, we wait to see what happens in Torrance as to whether that provides any answers to the shooting that has unfolded here. But there are 10 people deceased, 10 more people injured in hospital. And this community here, reeling. It had been Lunar New Year. There were celebrations. There was supposed to be 100,000 people here on the streets today. Instead, those celebrations have now been cancelled.
Right, looks like those answers might come soon too in Torrance. Jono, thank you so much. Appreciate it. Welcome back to the show. Breaking news. An update on that mass shooting in the US. You are now looking at chopper shots just in from local news station KTLA in LA, where law enforcement has actually surrounded a cargo van in a suburb in southwest LA. We need to make it clear that it's uncertain why authorities are surrounding that, but may be related, may not be related. It's yet to be confirmed. But that's a significant police operation underway in LA right now surrounding that van.
Yes, previously the man had been on the run, so we'll wait and see whether they have their man at the moment. CNN correspondent Natasha Chen is at the scene of the shooting. Thanks for your time this morning for us, Natasha. This is a city on edge now.
Absolutely. You know, speaking of the images that you're seeing from Torrance, California, where that police activity is happening, a law enforcement source has told my colleague Josh Campbell that that is ongoing police activity related to the investigation into this shooting that happened a couple blocks behind me here in Monterey Park. Now, that incident, that standoff happening, is about 30 miles southwest of where I am standing. It is closer to the coast. So this is more than 12 hours now after the initial shooting happened. And to remind folks that this is the suspect that police have told us they were looking for is an Asian man between the ages 30 and 50. Very little information given out because they told us that with the witness interviews, they were getting different descriptions and different descriptions of the gun as well. So this is definitely ongoing. There is mobile unit behind us with the Federal Bureau of Investigation. There are local sources here to federal sources, all trying to figure this out. And in the meantime, 10 people have died, 5 women, 5 men, and at least another 10 people brought to local hospitals. Carl and Sarah.
All right, Natasha, thank you. Just staying on those live shots for the moment. That is right across from a Walmart where 2 very heavily armed vehicles have managed to sandwich that white cargo van into place. We're unsure whether or not he's still inside, but there is a huge police presence not far from Shoppers on the side of the road as well.
It would be terrifying, wouldn't it? I mean, yeah. This is something that's caught them completely off guard at a time of celebration.
Yeah.
10 people dead, and the terror that you must feel of not knowing where the gunman is. Hopefully, they're closer.
Almost every day in LA. A manhunt is underway after a gunman opened fire at a dance studio in California, killing 10 people. The shooting occurred on Lunar New Year's Eve. Let's go live to US correspondent Jonathan Kearsley at the crime scene. John, the FBI and state authorities are involved in the investigation.
And the Department of Homeland Security now as well, Carl. There are a huge amount of resources is being thrown into investigating this shooting and also now trying to find the gunman. It was here yesterday. Thousands of people had gathered for Lunar New Year. And then just after 10 o'clock last night, inside that building off to my right, a gunman entered. He opened fire, killing 10 people, injuring another 10. Now, I understand that he actually made his way into that building by going through the car park just off to my right. You can see that area has been cordoned off. The officers are there, investigators are there, detectives have been there all morning. In that car park is the only entrance in and out of the dance studio where this shooting took place. There are security cameras there that may well have captured this man going in and out of that building. Now, police also looking at whether he then went to a secondary dance studio about 10 minutes to the drive north of here. Police say that a man there with a gun was tackled and then fled in a white van. Police looking at whether those two incidents are linked. But so serious is this, the President Joe Biden has been briefed on the investigation. The vice president speaking in Florida this morning, Kamala Harris, she said she offered her prayers to those who have been impacted and affected by this, to the victims, to their families, but also said she didn't want to see this type of violence again. As for the gunman, well, he remains still very much on the run. This is an area that is 65% Asian American. This part of Monterey had been celebrating Lunar New Year yesterday. The only description police have of the gunman so far is that he is an Asian male, and some people turning up to this crime scene this morning say they are still fearful to be on the streets given the gunman remains on the run.
I didn't expect this to happen to this community. You know, I grew up around here. I walked the streets. It was fairly safe at the time. And to hear that something like this has happened, it's very shocking and overwhelming.
Now, Lunar's celebrations have been due to continue here again today. 100,000 people had been expected to be lining these streets to take part in those festivities. That is now not going to take place. But, Carl, this shooting has had much wider and broader ramifications than just here in Los Angeles. New York and Chicago, they're beefing up their own resources on a policing front, taking units away from counterterrorism to try and deal with increasing security ahead of Lunar New Year festivities there. So this shooting, again, America dealing with tragedy and its wide-reaching consequences.
Jono, thank you.